students, we have one of the important kinds of nouns, namely material noun, to talk about. We had already discussed nouns like proper noun, common noun, collective noun and abstract noun. This time it is the fifth type of noun that you are going to undertake. We know that there are some things and some objects which are made of matters, or we can also say that some objects have material existence. On the other hand, there are some objects or things which have immaterial existence. So abstract noun was of immaterial existence because it does not have any impression on our sense, because there is no matter engaged in the making of that material noun. But when we talk about the noun like material noun, we must say that it has some kind of material existence, or this noun is made of certain kind of matter which remains in the state of solid, liquid or gas. So when we are talking about a noun which is made of matter, or which may live in the state of solid, liquid and gas, we can call it material noun. It is one point. Second point is that as these materials are to be measured, whatever matters we have, they are to be measured in terms of certain units. There are some physical units by which we can measure the quantity of material nouns. So we have developed some physical units like liter, kilogram, meter, to gauge the quantity of material nouns. So we can say that there are two ways by which we can use material noun in the sentence. First, we can use material noun as it is. For example, we have gold, silver, milk, gold, water, wool, meat, iron, oil, sugar, stone, pulse, rice, paper, bread, flour, wheat, ghee, brass, ink, tea, coffee, salt, chalk, chicken, drugs, wine. These are used in the sentence as they are. Like gold is used as gold when you are talking about gold. Or sometimes you can say we can use milk as milk when you are talking about milk. Now when we use material noun as it is, or just we want to give some expression about the material noun as such, we can use that material noun into singular number. We have the example. Now milk is a complete diet. What do you find here in the sentence? We find that milk is a material noun because it is composed of certain organic or inorganic substances. And here we are talking about milk in general. That is, it is a complete diet. It is what the information in general we want to reveal about milk. So it is just the general information, or some trait of that material noun is to be expressed. So in that way we can say that noun in the sentence remains into singular noun. But sometimes what happens, we are not talking about the noun in general term. Actually, for our daily use, we want to measure that noun, maybe in terms of kilo or liter. Now, the same material noun milk is used in the sentence in terms of kilos And in that way, we can say the subject becomes a plural in its number. Now, when there is just a unit to express the quantity of that material noun, and it is very much used as the subject, we can say the subject is into plural number. Now, I have underlined here, we can very much see that milk is a complete diet, and in second example we have 5 kilos of milk were in fridge. So here milk has been measured in terms of kilo, and the quantity of milk is 5 kilos. So 5 kilos of milk has become the subject for the sentence, and so in that way we can say that the subject is a plural number. Now we can say that the nouns are used either in terms of countability or uncountability. We can also say that of all 5 types of noun we have so far discussed, may either belong to countable group or may belong to uncountable group. You know, it is another criteria of countability or uncountability by which we can just describe the noun. And there are some just a references, or there are some usage of noun which depends on its being countability or uncountability. So in modern English grammar, noun has been also described in terms of countable noun or uncountable noun. So as the name itself implies, we can say that when we are able to count the number of noun in terms of natural number like 1, 2, 3, we can say that noun is countable noun, because we are able to count the number of the noun. So this kind of noun, that is countable noun, can be used in the sentence in both the number. It can be used in singular number and it can be used in plural number. Now we need looking at the numbers of the subject, whether that noun, countable noun, is used in singular number or it is used in plural number, and so accordingly the number of the subject is also decided. On the other hand, we can say that there are certain nouns which are never to be counted in terms of natural number like 1, 2, 3. When we talk about the noun like milk or honesty or responsibility, we can say that no, these nouns are not to be counted in terms of 1, 2, 3. We cannot say 1 love, 2 beauty and 3 responsibilities. It is very ridiculous to talk in that terms, because the nature of this noun is not to be counted in terms of natural number. So these are all uncountable nouns. And when we are talking about uncountable noun, they are generally used into singular number. So here we find that countable noun is used in both the numbers. It is used either in singular number or in plural number, depending upon the context in which that noun has been used. On the other hand, we can say that uncountable noun is always used into singular number, because there is no question of saying 2 duties, 2 honesty, 2 friendship, and so on. They are always remaining in the same form, that is in singular noun. So as subject also, or wherever it is used, we should try to keep the number of noun into singular only. Now of all 5 nouns that we have discussed, we can say that noun like common noun and collective noun are generally included into countable groups. Common noun is to be counted. It is why we find common noun is used in singular and plural number both. And on the other hand, we can see that collective noun in some cases are also counted. So you can use your collective noun also as countable noun. And because common noun and collective nouns are countable noun, so they can be used in both a singular and plural number. In contrast, you find that we have noun like proper noun, abstract noun, and material noun, which remain uncountable by their nature, except a few instances. You know, generally we can say that one name is always one. So, and honesty is always honesty, and silver is always silver. That is not to be counted anyway. So we can say that common and collective and abstract noun, being uncountable noun, are used into singular number only. Now we should also consider one remarkable point, that when we are talking about the countable noun, we see that it is sometimes accompanied by quantifiers. The new class of word has been made, although it is adjective itself, you know. Depending upon the function that adjective does in the sentence, we are making a class of adjective named quantifiers. And these quantifiers are used to give an idea of quantity of something in terms of numbers. How many? We can say that these things are just to give answer to the question how many. For example, how many boys were there? We can say a few boys were there, a few boys are there. And so how many is just a question mark that is to be explained by quantifiers. So what I want to tell you at this juncture is the fact that countable noun is very much used with certain quantifiers to express the quantity of that noun. We can say few, many, several are all quantifiers, and these are used with countable noun, especially common noun and collective noun. And so on the other hand, there are also quantifiers like little, much. These quantifiers are not used to give the quantity, rather the amount, how much, how many is to be expressed by few, many, and several, and how much is to be just expressed by little, much, and so on. How much curd is left? A little curd is left. Now here we have made the question by how much, that we want to know the quantity of curd left. And so by the quantifiers little, we have given answer to that amount and quantity. So here what I want to tell you, that generally material noun and abstract noun, sometime also little love is left, inhumanoid or plant and animals this time. So little love means no love is left. So it is what the quantity is just very much expressed of love by little. And here we find that we should notice one thing, that when we are going to express the quantity of numbers of common noun and collective noun, we use quantifiers like few and many and several. On the other hand, when we are going to express the quantity or amount of noun, of abstract noun and material noun, you are using the quantifiers like little, much, you know. In examination you can find certain kind of problem and certain kind of things for all of us. So this is also remarkable to notice when you are using countable and uncountable noun, because this is all helpful for further explaining the noun, like proper, common, whatever you have talked so much. And we should also consider one important point, that is determiner. Article is generally now described as determiner, and we can say that it is preceded a noun. So noun needs to be determined by article. So this is what article plays a role in the sentence. So generally it is a determiner, A, N, and E. And we can find that with common noun, most of the articles are used. This determiner, article, A, N, D are used with common noun. We hardly find any use of determiner, article, A, N, D with proper noun or with material noun. We cannot say a gold. Yes, in some case we can see the gold of Africa is precious. So that gold is used in a specific situation. But when we are talking about gold in general, we cannot use even the article. But yeah, the gold of Africa had been particularized. So in that situation, the article is used for material noun. Otherwise, it is not used before material noun itself. So we can say that article A and the A, N, and D are used with common noun and collective nouns, and we can also say with countable nouns. But they are hardly used with uncountable nouns, say material noun, abstract noun, or proper noun. So we also just find one thing that is very much important, that there are some syntactic criteria to describe a noun. I have made that syntactic criteria in table, you know. When we talk about our use of noun especially, we can say we should think whether it is in singular number or plural number, or we should also think that is there any numeral that we can use with it. Now we have further described numerals in terms of few, many, several. They are all quantifiers that we have already discussed. Now little, much, this is also quantifier. So it are in terms of definite article like the, and indefinite article like A and N. So we can say proper noun is used in singular number. We cannot find any use of proper noun into plural number, except we are making sentence like there were 5 Naveens in my class. Here we are not talking about a particular Naveen, rather we have counted. So that proper noun has been used as countable noun. Generally I have told you that proper noun is not countable noun, but in some specific situation like this, we have counted proper noun, so it has been used as proper noun. So in a specific situation, yes, it is used in plural number also, but we can say that no, proper noun is generally used in singular number. It is not used in plural number. There is no numerals. There is no use of few, many, several. There is no use of little, much. There is no use of any article before proper noun. So when you are just trying to use proper noun, you should see that proper noun should exclusively be used in singular number only. It should not be used into plural number. There should not be any numerals before it. There should not be any use of few, many, several. There should not be any use of little, much. And there should be no any use of determiner like A, N, and D before proper noun. Now coming to common noun, we can say that because it is countable noun also. So we can say that yes, it is used in both the numbers, singular and plural. We can say dog is barking, or we can also say dogs are barking. So in both the numbers, countable nouns are used or common nouns are used. Yes, there are numerals also that we can use. There were four dogs on the street. So four is numerals that we have used here. And then few, a few, the few, many, several are also used here with countable noun. So there were few dogs, but little, much is not used with countable noun. And yes, we can use a, an, and the article with countable noun or common noun. Now talking about uncountable noun, we can say that it is used only in singular number because it is uncountable in nature. So there should not be one. To have an existence, there should be at least one in number. So it is used in singular number. No plural number use is found of uncountable noun. No numeral is just preceded before uncountable noun. There is no use of few, many, several before uncountable noun. But yes, we can use little, much with uncountable noun. It is much sugar in tea. Here much is used with uncountable noun like sugar, and it is just a quantifier which is used with uncountable noun. And in some case we can say that the article you can use, the sugar of rayon was very sweet. So here the article has been used because you have made a particular use of sugar that was made by the sugar mill in at rayon. And there is no a or any article before just uncountable noun. Now talking about collective noun, we can say yes, it is countable in nature, so it is used in singular and plural number. It is sometimes used with numerals also. 100 families have been given flood reliefs, so we can say family is collective noun. But we are talking about the number, so 100 is used before it. Now you can also use few, many, several before family. Just a few family, a few families are left. So we should notice that when few, many, and several are used as quantifiers, the noun becomes plural number. And when just little, a little, or much is used, noun is used into singular number. It is why I have used just a few families have been left from relief, and you have used here just a family into plural number. And because it is countable, it is not uncountable, so we cannot use little and much. Yes, in some specific situation, a, an, and the article are used. A family was living here. Here it means that there was no definiteness of family. We don't have much information of family, so we have used within a article also. Now here talking about abstract noun, we can say it is used into singular number. Being uncountable noun, it is not used in plural. There is no numeral to be used with that abstract noun. So there is no case of using few, many, and several with abstract noun. Yes, in some case we can use little, much with abstract noun. You know, we have much love for our country, so love is used with much. And it is yes, in some case the article is used, but not a and an article are used. And finally, when you talk about material noun, we can say it is also just uncountable in nature, so you can use it also in singular number only. No plural number form is used, and so there is no numerals before it. We cannot say one gold, two gold, three golds. Yes, one just piece of gold, we can say like that. But it is not gold acids which is preceded by any numerals. No, few, many, and several is used before it. And yes, sometimes much little used because it is uncountable in nature. In some specific situation, the article is used, but we don't find any A article used before it. So these are all semantic criteria of all the five types of noun: proper, common, collective, material, abstract, countable, and uncountable. And when you take into account all these semantic criteria, they can help us correctly use the noun into the sentence when you are speaking and writing. And we can, some of the questions asked in our examination also, to fill in the blanks with the article there too, we can see what kind of noun is there. So we can sum up article questions there. You know, most often we are also asked the question to fill up the blanks with quantifiers like little, much, few, or many. In that case too, we can go through this. Most often we are asked to give the proper number of the noun. There too we can consider whether noun is just a proper or common or collective. Or when we have some common errors, these semantic criteria may help us detect the errors about noun, and we can just secure good marks in competitive examination as well. So we have all here just a very good information about the noun that I have given, and I hope you